This is my first time opening up Proton Auth, and I wanted to get it on camera, but I did some research beforehand to also fill you in on details. Now, I am coming from Ente Auth, which is what I've been using for probably the last year now, and it's by far my favorite recommendation. Kind of what I'm looking for is how it compares to Ente Auth, if I maybe want to switch over to it, why I might want to do that. So yes, Proton Authenticator is Proton's brand new service. It is not formally like branded as part of Proton Pass, which is interesting, which is their password manager. Like, this is its own kind of service that they're pushing, and they just rolled it out not too long ago. It's already got its own website, and on paper this actually has some really good stuff, like you can use it without a Proton account and really cool things. So I just opened the app and go started. So I am going to try the import, and I pretty much exported my Ente codes, and I did try to use the encrypted backup, which I don't think is going to work, but we'll give it a shot. So they have Ente Auth here as an option. Setting, and it does say you have to choose plain text. So sadly, you can't import Ente Auth with the encryption. What this means is that when you export your codes from another client, like from Ente Auth, you're given the option to either do something encrypted where the file itself in transit, so you can share the file around, doesn't actually store your TOTP seeds in plain text, so anybody can read them. So it is kind of unfortunate that I do have to do a plain text export in this situation. Now let's try importing. And it should have imported everything. Let's see, Face ID. And now they do have sync, but only over iCloud according to this. Now, this is a really important thing to touch on. There was a provider called 2FAS, and this is a bit more technical and I fully don't understand it myself, but essentially as a developer on the iOS platform, you have to essentially opt your app to be compatible with iCloud end-to-end encryption via ADP. 2FAS back in the day wasn't doing that, which is why some people moved away from 2FAS because their sync wasn't using Apple's end-to-end encryption. I am unclear what Proton is doing here, so I would love to get more clarification on that. All I can find on their website is that they allow you to sync over iCloud, but I don't see this specifically mentioned anywhere. So they do say you can sync with your Proton account, so you're kind of in a situation where you have to pick here. I'll touch on this later. For now, I'm gonna skip, and it does default to showing all your codes. I actually don't like all my codes showing by default, so I'm gonna see if I can turn that off, and of course, I'm gonna blur this, which is gonna create some time in post. If we go to settings, you can do a backup, which will periodically sync to iCloud, but they also have a sync between devices function, which looks like is the function that goes through Proton. So if you do want proper end-to-end encryption across all devices, including for Android, including for Linux, if you're using this on multiple devices outside the Apple ecosystem, you definitely want to use this if you're interested in sync. It's got a system theme, which I think is great. I like how you can change the search position, the digital style. You can do plain or boxed. I don't like that. I don't like boxed. There's an animate code change, haptic feedback, focus search on launch. I actually do like that. Every time I open up my 2FA app, I want it to go straight to the search so I can just search for what I need. To add something new, you can point a QR code or you can enter details manually. And here are the advanced options for you guys. It does support Steam codes, which is cool. Steam has its own TOTP thing. It's ridiculous, but you can essentially use your Steam accounts with this, which is awesome. If we head over to desktop, it looks like it's just through the Apple Mac App Store, and it's just a blown up version of the iOS one, as far as I can tell. So yeah, you can just skip all this. And yeah, it looks pretty much identical. This settings page here is not so great. Maybe you can hear my scroll bar and how this scrolls. It really is the iPhone version blown up. Well, like I said, I'm using Ente Auth, so I want to give a general overview of what Ente Auth provides. It's open source, like Proton Auth is. It is also end-to-end encrypted, except Ente only does its end-to-end encryption via its own Ente account. So the only way to do end-to-end encryption with this is with Ente, and Proton makes you do it through Proton. Now, both of them, both Proton Auth and Ente Auth, can be used offline without an account if you're somebody who prefers to keep this all local on one device, essentially air-gapped. And again, I'll touch on if you should do this shortly. One thing I do prefer about Ente Auth is that it is just straight available on F-Droid on any of your Android devices, whereas as of right now, at least, Proton Authenticator seems to only be available on official app stores, with the exception of their desktop program. So the Mac one is only on the App Store, like I just said, but the Windows and Linux one actually are things that you can just straight download from the site. And as for packages, you're going to get .deb and .rpm, which should cover at least the basics for a lot of you. But it would be cool to see something like a Flatpak or something like that. And the Android app is only available on the Google Play Store. Sadly, they don't post releases, so you can't just get the APK from their GitHub repo, as far as I can tell, and they only allow you to get it from the Google Play Store. This actually has been confirmed to work by some of our community members on de-Googled phones, including Graphene, including things even without any compatibility layer. So this should work for really any device out there, but they only let you get it from the Play Store. They also publish the iOS source code as well, but you probably won't expect to get releases for iOS outside of the App Store, and that's just the way Apple wants things done. On the other hand, if I go to Ente's GitHub repo, you'll actually see Auth had a recent release, and you can go ahead and pull up assets, which includes literally everything you need right here, including an APK, including a DMG. So you could download this on a Mac without needing to be logged into an Apple account, or you could download this on an Android device without needing to be logged into a Google account, which is something that I hope Proton does as well. The other really important thing here, I don't want to fearmonger or anything. This is a pretty normal part of creating new software, going to find bugs, and it's why I tend to wait to list things. But there was a short bug that they have already fixed, where essentially if you filed a bug report, it would actually include the seeds of your TOTP codes in the bug report. So theoretically, there was this situation where you would share that information with Proton. Now, they have already fixed this. It does seem like an honest mistake, albeit a bit rushed and probably shouldn't have happened in the first place. When Proton Pass was first released, people did find a couple issues with it as well, and they reported it, and those are now fixed. And years later, Proton Pass is a really cool, really solid offering. So I don't think that this is like a long-term concern of mine, especially with how simple Auth clients really are, and the fact you can use this offline, and the fact it's open source leaves me pretty good. Okay, so let me give you guys actionable takeaways. And some context here, I currently use Proton Pass as my main password manager. And I use Ente Auth for my TOTP. And I do sync Ente Auth with the end-to-end encryption feature. So let me kind of give you my takeaways as well as what I'd recommend for most of you. One, if you're deciding between Proton Auth versus Ente and you're currently using something like Google Authenticator or literally anything else like Authy, these are both fantastic offerings. You can't go wrong with either of them. You're literally comparing the cream of the crop. Is that what it is? Cream of the crop? Anyway, you're comparing the best two services out there on the market, and you can't go wrong with either of them. They're both open source. They both offer end-to-end encrypted syncing. They're both from pretty trustworthy organizations as a whole. And they both offer pretty okay interfaces and will get the job done and still give you access to your seeds. It's actually a dark pattern that these services like Authy and LastPass do, where they essentially lock your seed that you originally do when you scan your QR code so that you can't access it again to purposely make it hard for you to move off of those services. I covered this in my TOTP guide. It's very thorough if you actually want to thoroughly understand all this technology, but pretty much you want something that lets you view your seeds. And just to prove you can, I pulled up the Proton Pass and you can, I don't want to tap it, so I have one more thing to blur, but when I tap secret inside of an entry, it actually does reveal the secret, and this is the one that I imported from Ente Auth. So when you use any of these providers, you are properly owning your codes and you can freely move between different ecosystems. I'm gonna be watching it to see if they release any cool features that might convince me to move from Ente Auth, but right now Ente Auth is just a little bit more flexible for me. Now, one really interesting demographic out there is people who keep their TOTP codes in their password manager, specifically Proton Pass, which I have installed right here. You can actually use the password manager as your TOTP client, but now they're offering this dedicated thing. Why they're doing this is because it is technically a bit more secure to have your TOTP codes in a separate location. That means that someone has to essentially get access to two different secure vaults now to break into your accounts. So it is undeniably a security benefit. Most attacks aren't going to be this sophisticated. And for most people out there, they just need to enable 2FA to get 80 to 90% of the benefit. And it doesn't matter if it's stored in their password manager or in a dedicated TOTP app. If you are somebody who's in the Proton Pass ecosystem, I would ask yourself why you were keeping your codes already in Proton Pass and why you weren't using something dedicated like Ente Auth. If it's because you didn't feel like you had a trusted company or you wanted to keep things in the Proton ecosystem and you would have preferred a dedicated app, but they didn't offer that before, then yes, maybe go ahead and start importing those and migrating those TOTP codes to Proton Authenticator, and then you can either keep it offline or still do end-to-end encryption sync with your Proton account, which is currently what I'd recommend since it's a bit unclear what they're doing in the iCloud system right now. With that said, if you're somebody who is keeping your codes in Proton Pass, the password manager, and your reasoning for that was purely convenience, and you don't really care about the extra security you'll find from a dedicated app, then this won't change that for you. You're going to be in the same place. So I don't know if that's the right move for you. To summarize all of that, if you're using something like Google Authenticator, Authy, etc., make sure to migrate to either Ente Auth or Proton Auth. It doesn't really matter. Just move to something open source that gives you real ownership. If you're currently on Ente Auth, I don't know if it's worth moving to Proton Auth unless you just like Proton or you like the look of this or you just want to get in early or you didn't like Ente for whatever reason. I don't know what your reasons might be. I will probably wait to switch if I ever do. I'll see what this does, but that's where I'm coming from. And if you keep your TOTP codes in a password manager like Proton Pass or any other password manager, I would ask yourself, were you doing it for convenience? If so, this probably won't change too much for you. But if you were doing it because you didn't feel like you had a trusted company that was building a nice authenticator for you and this changes things for you, then maybe now it's worth the switch. As for whether or not you should enable end-to-end encrypted syncing, that's going to depend on how much security you want. Technically, keeping it fully offline on just a device is going to be the most secure, but I would recommend for a lot of people, like if I was chatting with friends or family, I would say enable the sync so that way if you lose the device, you have an easy backup. It shouldn't be your main backup, but it does reduce the likelihood of something going wrong with a very, 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 very minuscule trade-off for security. So I think for most people, it's a worthy sacrifice. And if you're my friend or family member, I would probably say iCloud is okay, but we don't really know the full details of that yet. And if you're somebody who's a little bit more picky about this stuff, I would recommend Proton Sync until we know more information about how they handle iCloud. I'd love to know your thoughts. Please leave them below. Have you tested it out? Have you discovered something I didn't? Let the community know below. There's a whole thread on our forum about this, so definitely check it out. A lot of people have been discussing this for a while now at discuss.techlore.tech. And the last thing, I like to make all this info as public and free as I can. So if you guys like it and you want to support the work that's going on back here at Techlore, you can do that by either using a Proton affiliate link if you're going to register for Proton and it's a good fit for you. And there's a non-affiliate link there too to just the regular Proton Auth website. And if you're already a Proton subscriber or you're not really planning to do it, but you still like this content, you can support us directly by becoming a Techlorian. We have a private Signal group just for those Techlorians. And you also get to support this free content. You can also become a member on YouTube. And there's some really cool perks that's tied to all that. And you can find it all in a description. Thank you all for watching. And I'll see you next time on Techlore.